Hello and welcome. In this very quick session, I'm going to show you a different way of calling a class and calling the class attributes and functions. Until now, all the examples that we have seen until now, we have created the main method within the class and we have added the data to create objects and call the class instance and variables and functions within the class. So if I go to my Eclipse and I go to the project and go to the Oops folder. So these are the two examples that we have discussed till now in the earlier session, a student class and a car class. And in both of these classes, you can see we have a main method within the class and then we have created the objects and then called the class attributes and functions from the main method within the class. The same thing we have seen in the last session where we created a car class and then again within the car class we had a main method and we created the objects and using the objects we accessed the attributes and functions of the class. Now you can do this separately from outside the class. So if I go to my package and do a right click, new, others, and I will search for Groovy, you can select Groovy class if you have the option or go to Groovy type and say next. And here I'm going to say car objects. So I'm going to create the objects for the car class and I will say next and I will select static void main method and say finish. So I have created a separate class with a main method. Now I'm going to go back to my car class, and just in case you have not seen the last session where I created this car class, you can watch that. And here I'm just going to copy all the data from the main method of the car class and I will copy this and add it inside the main method of the car objects class, and that's it. I have not done any change, and I can in fact go and comment this out or delete this method from this class. So I can in fact just delete everything, and you can see this is now our car class, which only has the attributes and functions of the car class, and then we have a separate class for creating and calling the objects and then calling the attributes and functions using the objects of the car class. And I'm going to now run this car objects class. Do a right click, run as. If you have Groovy script, you can check that, or Java application should also work. And you can see we are getting the same output. So you can also do this from outside the class. And generally in object oriented programming, we do like this. We have the classes created separately with only having the attributes and the functions, and all the objects are created separately. So this was a very simple example I wanted to show you, that we can also access the class attributes and functions using class objects that are created outside the class. I hope this session was useful. Thank you for watching.